All right, we want to welcome you back to Wednesday night preaching at the pastors. I'm so thankful for all those that came out for the Mother's Day service. We hope you've had a great week so far. We're excited about tonight. We are looking forward to hear Brother Mike Webb preach to us tonight. So we want you to go grab your Bibles and get ready. We're getting ready to have Brother Michael come on. Michael, he's getting ready to preach to our hearts. Grab your Bibles. We want you to tune in and share the page, share the post. Comment. Let us know that you're here. We want to pray for you. If you got a prayer request, put that in the comments. We're looking forward to what Brother Michael brings to us tonight. So you sit back, pray for him as he comes. Grab your Bibles and participate tonight. Give him one of them shout emojis. Amen. Have you ever had a shout emoji, Brother Michael?
I have not.
All right. Preach!
Good evening, everyone. Take your Bibles and turn to John chapter 3. John chapter 3, God put this on my heart a week or so ago, this thought and simple thought tonight. And I'm kind of like my pastor says, simple thoughts, simple food, simple people.
Yes, sir.
So this will be real simple tonight. I'm going to read one verse tonight. Everybody knows this verse. Everybody probably, the majority of the people in this world probably can quote this verse if they can read tonight or even if they can't. But we're going to read John 3:16 tonight. John chapter 3 verse 16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Let us pray. Lord Heavenly Father, we thank you, Father, for this day. Father, we thank you, Father, for this opportunity, Father, to preach tonight, Father. Oh, Father, I don't take it lightly to stand, Father, no matter where I am, Father. And I pray, Father, that you stand with me tonight, Father, and help me, Father. Give me the words to say, Father. I pray, Father, that you just preach through me, Father, and something I say might help someone, Father. Help me to remember who I'm preaching about, Father. Oh, Father, I pray, Father, that you just help me to give, Father, just a little bit, Father, what you've given me. Let it be a help, Father, to those. Be with us during this time, Father. Bless all that takes place, Father, and we'll give you all the praise, honor, and glory for everything. All these things we ask in Christ Jesus' name. Amen. John chapter 3, verse 16. Let me read that one more time before I get started. It says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." I guess you could say, or I would say, this is a very familiar verse. Probably, in my opinion, it's one of the most popular verses in the Bible, if not the most popular verse. Sure, many of us can quote this verse and know this verse and learn it as a little child growing up. If you go to in a store, you'll see this verse on t-shirts, you'll see it on coffee mugs, you'll see it on a sign in a house. You'll see this verse anywhere and everywhere. And the world knows this verse, and the world takes this verse out of context per se, and they use it for different things. I remember as I was studying this, I remember even a wrestler that had this verse on his t-shirt per se. But what I'm trying to say is everybody knows John 3:16. Everybody knows this verse. And you might say, Brother Michael, if everybody knows this verse, why are you telling us about it tonight? Why are you reading John 3:16? Well, I want to share for just a little bit on this thought, and that's the thought God gave me, is that is God loves you.
Yes, sir.
God loves you.
Preach.
Now, why would I be talking about that tonight? Say, Brother Michael, we all know this verse. We all know that God loves us. Well, let me say, sometimes it's good to have a reminder tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes it's good to be reminded of the things of the Bible and the things of God. See, David knew that God loved him. When David walked out, he looked up at the skies and he seen the stars in the skies and he seen the creation upon this world. And he said, What God hath mindeth a man? What has God mindeth a man? How can God love me when I look out and see all this creation tonight? It would do us good to walk out our front doors and look up at the skies and see the sun and the stars hanging and see everything that God has done for us and everything that God has given us, and we would be reminded tonight of the love of God, that God loves us. But oftentimes we forget this. We go through life and we go through every day and we go through things like we're going through today in this time in the world that we're living in. And it's easy to forget that God loves us.
Yes.
And God loves you. But the truth of the matter is God does love us. And God loves each and every one of us tonight. Let me say, brother, you better say, Brother Michael, does God love me? Who are you speaking of tonight that God loves? Well, God loves you. And God loves me. And as in this verse I just read, it said, for God so loved the world. The world pretty much tells me that's everyone. God loves everybody. Yes, there's not one person that God does not love. God loves the church member in the choir. God loves the deacon that shouts and stands every Sunday morning. God loves the preacher that mounts the pulpit every Sunday morning. But God loves that drug dealer in the streets tonight. God loves that prostitute standing on the corner tonight. God loves that one holding that beer bottle tonight. God loves that one sitting on that drunken stool tonight. God loves Nancy Pelosi tonight. Say, Brother Michael, what are you saying? It's true. God loves everybody. There's not one person on this earth that God does not love. God loves you. And God loves me.
Yes, sir.
See, what matters is what we do with that love. It's not bad. It does not matter what God loves, because God loves everyone. You say, Brother Michael, how can someone go to hell tonight? God doesn't send nobody to hell. If we go to hell, that's our choice.
Yes, sir.
I have a choice to make. I can either go to heaven or I can go to hell. But that's my choice.
Yes, sir.
But there's one choice I cannot make, as Brother Joe Author says. I cannot stay here. But I must go somewhere. And it is not God that sends me to hell if I go. But it's myself for refusing Him. And I'll talk on that here in a minute. But what I'm saying is God loves everyone tonight.
Yes, sir.
God loves the whole world. How much does God love us? How much does God love us tonight? Well, that verse tells us that too. It says He loved us enough that He gave His only begotten Son.
Amen.
Oh, God loved me enough that He gave His only Son, Jesus Christ, to go on a cross and die and be crucified for me. And I can't even think all that Jesus went through. But see, Jesus didn't have to do that. But Jesus chose to do that. God didn't have to give Him to us to be our propitiation of our sin tonight, but He chose to. John 15:3, I could probably quote this, but I'm going to read it so I don't mess it up. John 15:13 says, greater love had no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. See, this verse is telling us that there's no greater love than someone gives his life for his friends. I'm not saying tonight, we're Jesus Christ's friends. I'm His friend tonight, and He loved me enough to die for me upon that cross. And He loved you tonight to die for you. Oh, Jesus loves us tonight. Romans 5:8 says, but God commandeth His love toward us, and while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. See, that's one of my favorite verses in the Bible. And what that verse means to me is, when I was living in the world and living in sin and doing wrong and doing things that I shouldn't have been doing, God loved me then.
Yes, sir.
God loved me just as much then as He loves me now. And oh, I'm thankful for the day that I got saved and I called upon Him and He took me into the fold tonight. But God loves us always. He loves the sinner. He loves the saint. God loves everyone tonight. Oh, God's love tonight. So tonight while I'm preaching, why don't you just think for a moment about God's love? Be reminded of God's love tonight. Say, Brother Michael, that's a simple thought. Oh, yes, it's simple. We can preach on this verse right here till eternity, till Jesus comes back and we couldn't get it done. Oh, the love of God tonight. And let me ask you this question. Do you love God? I said God loves us, but do you love God tonight? How much do we love God? Well, I say I love my wife tonight. And I do. I'm thankful for my wife. I'm thankful for the day that we met. I'm thankful for the day that we got married, and I love her tonight. I love my mama tonight. I have a love for my mama that I don't have for no one else. And Sheena will tell you this, I'm a little bit spoiled and I say a mama's boy per se, but I have a love for my mama tonight that I don't have for no one else. I have a love for my daddy tonight. I have a love for my grandparents and my aunts and uncles and my cousins. I have a love for my church tonight. I have a love for the church members tonight. I have a love for my brothers and sisters in Christ tonight. And if you're watching this video tonight, I love you tonight. We have a love tonight. I have a love for everyone. We have a love in our hearts. If God saves us, we will love tonight. What's one thing all those things have in common? See, there's a different type of love. I love my wife different than I love God. We love differently. But in all those things I said, I was thinking of this, and there's one thing in common with all those things that I just named, that type of love. And that word is a relationship. I have a relationship with my wife that I don't have with no one else. I have a relationship with my mama that I don't have with no one else. I have a relationship with my church that I don't have with no one else. See, in order for us to love God, we must have a relationship tonight with Him. And Nicodemus in John chapter 3 before verse 16, if you read those previous verses, Nicodemus comes to Jesus and he says, Jesus, what must I do to be born again? And then verse number 6, let me read it here. It says, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Jesus is telling Nicodemus, Nicodemus, you think I'm talking of a physical birth, but I'm not talking of a physical birth. I'm talking of a spiritual birth tonight. See, when one is born, they become into a relationship tonight. And what I'm saying is, when we're born into the fold, the family of Jesus Christ, when we kneel down and accept Him into our heart, and we get saved tonight, we become into a relationship with Him. Do you have a relationship with Jesus tonight? Are you in a relationship with Christ? We can be in many kinds of relationships, but the most important one you'll ever have is if you make a relationship with Jesus tonight. John 5, let me turn to John. 1 John 5, verse 3 through 6. 1 John 5, verse 3 through 6 says, for this is the love of God, that we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not grievous. For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Who is he that overcometh the world but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? This is he that came by water and blood, even Jesus Christ, not by water only, but by water and blood. And it is the Spirit that beareth witness, because the Spirit is true. These verses here are telling us how we can have a relationship with them. To me, what they're saying is, in order to have that relationship with Jesus, in order to love Jesus Christ, we must be born again. We must be saved tonight. And if you're saved, you will love Jesus tonight. It's impossible to be saved and not love God. And let me say this, and I hadn't planned on it, but it's impossible to be saved and love God and not love your brethren tonight. 1 John chapter 4 talks about how if we love God, we'll love our brothers. And it says if we love not our brethren, then the love of God is not in us. So if you're listening to me and if you say, Brother Michael, there's people I just don't like. There's people I don't get along with. You might even say the word H-A-T-E, I hate them. Well, if you say that word, I ask you, do you really love God tonight? Because the Bible tells us if we love our brethren, we'll love God. How's our relationship with Jesus Christ tonight? Do we love Him? And not only if we love Him, we'll be saved, but if we loved Him, we will do right. 1 John that I just read, 5, verse 3 says, for this is the love of God, that we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not grievous. You know, we sin and I sin daily and we're all going to mess up and we're all going to do wrong. But we will have a want to in our heart after we get saved. We'll want to do right. We'll want to sin less. And I believe if we truly get saved, now I know there's some people that go through different things. And you may have a harder time after you get saved to do things that I might do that we say are right and wrong. But overall, if God truly does a work in your heart, He will make a way for you to do right. Right, and you will want to keep His commandments tonight. We will want to do right.
Yes, sir.
So I'm asking you this, do you want to do right? Do you want to live for Him? I work at a place and everywhere you go, people say they love Jesus. People say they're a Christian, they're saved. But when you listen to them all day long, you hear words that I don't think comes out of a Christian's mouth. I can't help but think in my heart, do you really love God tonight? Because it says, if I love him, I'll keep his commandments. And I'll do the things that are right. And if we love God, there'll be a difference about us. There'll be a difference in the way we live. I told this before, but the moment I got saved, the Sunday morning I got saved, I went into work that Sunday night, and this lady looked at me and said, there's something different about you. What I'm saying is, I believe when we get saved, there'll be a difference about us.
Yes,
and the world will be able to tell it tonight. And I'm going to finish on this point, and this is my last point right here, my last thought tonight. If we love God, and God loves you, we know God loves you, then if God loves us, there is no reason to fear tonight.
Oh, that's good.
We have no reason to fear.
Yes, sir.
1 John 4, verse 18. 1 John 4, verse 18 says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear. Because fear hath torment.
Oh,
he that feareth is not made perfect in love. You know, God is perfect tonight.
Yeah.
And if God loves me, and we know he does, because I just read it there in verse 16, John chapter 3, and I said God loves everyone.
Sure.
So if God loves you, and I love God, meaning I am saved and I'm a child of his, and I'm born again and I am in that relationship. That verse I just read is telling me this. I have no reason to fear tonight. We fear things and we go through things. And people are scared to even go out of their houses today. They don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what's going to happen. But I can't go through the world with the fear in my heart, because God loves me. And if he loves me tonight, I have no reason to fear. 2 Timothy 1:7 says, for God hath, it is not the spirit of fear, but the power of love and a sound mind. I messed that verse up, but we all know what it is. God is the spirit of love tonight. If we're saved, God gives us love. But if we don't have the reason to fear, y'all know who fear comes from? Fear does not come from God. But fear comes from Satan and the devil tonight. So if we're fearful, if we're afraid what's going to happen, that comes from the devil. The devil wants to make us fear. All across this country today, there's people living in fear. There's people not going to work. There's people not going to see their grandkids. There's people not going to the grocery store. They're calling and ordering their groceries. I ain't got time to live in fear, because God loves me. And if God loves me, I'm not worried about nothing tonight.
Amen.
God will take care of everything. I haven't missed one paycheck. I haven't missed one meal. I haven't went hungry one night. I haven't went to the house wondering where I was going to sleep. But my God's took care of me every day and every night. And he loves me. So why should I worry? Why should I fear when this very same Jesus lives so near? Oh, God loves us tonight, church. And I'm just trying to give you a little simple reminder. God loves you. And God loves me. And as I finish that, Brother Michael, you don't know what I've done. You don't know what I am. You don't know where I live. No, I do not. You may be listening to me and say, I just feel like nobody loves me. I feel like I don't have a daddy. I feel like I don't have a mama. I feel like I come home and have to go through the refrigerator and look for food, and my mama's gone off and I don't know when she's coming in. You may feel like there's no one in this world that loves you. Let me tell you, I'm telling you right now, there's one person that does love you, and that's Jesus Christ. And God loves you, for God so loveth the world. That world covers everybody. It even covers Nancy Pelosi. God, I hope she gets saved, but I don't think she is right now. But what I'm saying is, God loves everyone.
Sure.
Oh, God loves you tonight. And there's not one thing you've done that can hinder that love of God.
Right.
You are not too bad for him. So if you're listening to this, and as I finish, if you're not saved, I pray that you'd give your life to him. Start that relationship and know this. There's no reason to fear, because God loves us. I want to pray and we're going to be dismissed. And finish our night. Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you, Father, for this day. Father, we thank you, Father, for this message, Father. I pray, Father, something I said would have helped somebody, Father. I pray, Father, you just remind us tonight, Father. Oh, Father, that you love us tonight. Father, I'm thankful for your love tonight. I'm thankful when I go home, Father, my wife's going to wrap her arms around me. And she's going to tell me she loves me tonight. Oh, Father, but greater than that love with her. You're going to lay down beside of me tonight, God, when I pull up my head, and that love's going to be there. When I get up in the morning, Father, you're going to love me the same. There's nothing I can do to hinder that love, and I'm so thankful for your love tonight. Oh, Father, I pray if there's one listening to me, Father, if they don't know that love, Father, they would come to know you before it's too late. Oh, Father, help us in these days we're living in. Help us to come out victorious. Father, I pray for my church that you bless it. I pray, Father, for my pastors, Father, that you just shine your love upon them and their families, Father. And you just help us, Father, to live for you. Oh, Father, and I pray that you'd help us to love you in return like you deserve and desire to be loved. Oh, Father, I just love you tonight. I thank you, Father, all you've done, all you're going to do. All these things I ask in Christ Jesus' name. Amen.